It's important to remember that the Federal Reserve is the bank that lends money to banks. So when we have an environment in the economy where inflation is getting out of control, so right now it's in the eights, which are some of the highest numbers that we've seen probably in 40 years. So the Federal Reserve has to step in and use the tools that it can to try to bring that cost back down to make things more affordable for folks on a day-to-day basis. Going to the grocery store, purchasing a car, a lot of the services that folks use on a day-to-day basis are all being impacted by the inflation. The Federal Reserve will raise the interest rates so that the money that's being lent out in the form of credit cards, car loans, other types of short-term financing increases, which slows spending down. Once spending comes down, inflation will follow. It's just one of the tools that they use. Something that's a little different right now that a lot of folks are not taking into consideration is we're still having after effects of COVID. COVID affected the supply chain. So there are a lot of products and a lot of things that people typically use on a day-to-day basis that haven't been available in the quantities that they used to be. So we're still running into some of the shortages, some of the things you would purchase off the shelf, clothing, different items, even the effect that COVID has had on the car industry with decreasing the number of chips that are available. So what happens is those costs go up and it mimics standard inflation. So there's a couple of things that actually come into play there. But the goal is to try to slow the spending and at least do something to try to get the inflation under control. So yeah, it's a little bit unusual because you would think to yourself, well, wait, the cost is going up because people are trying to purchase things and there's not a lot of supply, but now we're going to slow them down from spending. What kind of an effect is that going to have on the economy with businesses? That's going to slow down the amount of product that the businesses are able to move. It doesn't look like the Federal Reserve is going to slow its effort anytime soon to continue to increase rates, slow the inflation. They've already made 4 increases so far, and inflation is still in the 8s. Their goal is to try to get it down into the 2s. That's quite a spread, and it's going to take some period of time to actually get it to that point. So it doesn't look like that's going to slow down anytime soon. You have folks that are going to want to prepare for Christmas, especially after the pandemic, and get back together with family and experience Christmas again or New Year's. It's going to be really difficult because the cost of everything is going to be higher. And on the other hand, you think the average person would like to have cash in their bank account so that they are, you know, in a situation where if they need something that they can pay cash for, they have it readily on hand. So it is kind of a difficult situation for sure. I think most folks are going to have a difficult time navigating the holidays this year. What the Federal Reserve typically does is they always have a press meeting after they make an announcement. In the press meeting today, they continued to reinforce the idea that they're just going to stay on this and keep pushing with the same type of pressure until they see inflation come back. You have to realize that even when that happens, it's not going to be an automatic, instant turn back around of the rate. It's going to be a situation where they're going to keep raising it, and then they're going to look for it to consistently hold at a certain level and for the cost of a lot of the product that's out there to start to come down. So the day-to-day stuff that folks use in their home or the services they use start to become affordable again. They're going to look for that to stay at a certain level of affordability for a period of time before they start slowly bringing the rates back down. So this is an environment that's probably going to be with us for a little bit. More than ever, especially with what we've experienced over the past couple of years with the pandemic and the shortage of product or the inability to get to certain services, I think every family, every individual should take the time to sit down and kind of reevaluate everything. Look at the income that you have, look at the typical expenses that you have, and just strategize how and where you're spending your money. It is definitely a difficult landscape to navigate. So having some type of a plan and not just kind of winging it is probably the only advice that I could give. Every person's situation is going to be so drastically different depending on what they're experiencing in their life and the stuff that they use on an ongoing basis, whether they plan to purchase a home, need to purchase a car, just about anything that you would use financing for is going to be a little bit on the high end for a while. So really just sitting down and making sure you structure your budget, stay on top of it the best that you can. With regard to mortgage rates specifically, they typically buy on the rumors, sell on the facts. So ahead of this meeting today, we saw the mortgage rates ticking up a little bit. And then once they make an announcement, they pull them back just a tad to adjust to where things should actually be. Everything else, you will see it progressively start to factor into the interest rate on your credit cards, car loans, any other type of short-term financing that folks use. You always have the option of reaching out to any creditor that you work with, especially credit cards, and discussing the interest rate of the credit card with the creditor. Most of the time, the original application you submitted and the interest environment that you were approved under is how they determine the trajectory of your interest rate throughout the years. So perhaps your credit has improved, maybe you have a little less debt, maybe there's something different about your situation that if you go back to your credit card and discuss it with them, they may be able to lower the rate, certainly. Or you can always look into credit cards with your bank, your credit union, find out where their rates are at, or their websites that you can go to that will help you select credit cards that are better for your situation. Might have points that you can use for something or lower rates based on the environment that you're in. There's always companies offering some type of promotional. And you have to remember that these companies make money off of lending the money out. So they are going to be trying to compete with each other to try to keep the rates back a little bit as well. I think that the biggest point to remember during a time like this is that it's a cycle. There's an effort being made to get the cost of living under control, and as that plays out, things will adjust back again. This is an attempt to actually help the public get the cost of things under control. So your groceries, your car purchase, your clothing purchase, anything else that you might have becomes a little bit more affordable for you. So keeping that in mind and remembering that it is a cycle and that you can continue to live your life, work through it, just budget, do the best you can to navigate it, be aware of what the rates are if you are going to borrow anything, and just keep in mind that your financial environment is something you constantly revisit through the years. Each year you want to sit down with your significant other or with a financial planner and kind of overlook everything and make sure that you're on course to accomplish the financial goals that you're after. In other words, it's not the end of the world. Life will continue. It just squeezes a little bit. So not fun, but we'll get through it, and just keep your focus.